Many people feel that last Thursday's flash crash had all the makings of a classic black swan event, an unforeseen, highly improbable occurrence that blindsided pretty much everybody. But in retrospect, was it all inevitable? And perhaps in the ultimate irony of ironies, the man who coined the term the black swan, Nassim Taleb, was advising the hedge fund that made one of the trades that was involved in that particular incident. The Wall Street Journal claims that that fund was behind the bearish options bet that initially sparked the 1,000-point decline on the Dow. First on CNBC, we are pleased to welcome Nassim Taleb to Power Lunch. Good to see you, Nassim.
Hi,
it's been about a year since we've had a chance to talk to you.
11 months off the air.
You went into a self-imposed hiatus.
Exile, yes.
So you've had a year to take a look at these markets, and I understand that you cannot talk about Thursday's event.
I don't want to talk about Thursday's event. I have no clue about Thursday events.
Yeah, neither does anyone.
Wait a second. I need to clarify. Cannot talk or do not want to talk?
Both.
Both. Okay.
Plus, they're irrelevant. They're not my. I don't know anything about Thursday's events.
Well, let me put it this way. Yeah. Given what you've written about, given your.
But there's more important things to talk about than Thursday's events.
I understand. I just have one question. With what you know, have seen, heard reported about Thursday's event, does it strike you as having the characteristics of a black swan?
I don't have enough facts to talk about Thursday's events.
Okay, well, give us something that you think is far more important.
Vastly more important.
You want to talk about options.
Options
in the government debt market. You think it's fragile.
I spent a year away from you guys, from the world, almost a year. And I'm emerging. I'm coming back because of my book is out. And I've looked at the world, and I realize the world is vastly more fragile than it was when I left it. Mm-hmm. See, I thought something would be fixed. Things are getting worse. The crisis of 2008 was caused by debt. Okay, fragility, debt, hidden risks, and irresponsible risk management. Everything I see today, makes me worry because we have more debt, more irresponsible risk management, particularly in the administration, a lower tax base and more hidden risks. And when you talk about auctions, I feel a tinge of worry because we're going to talk a lot more about auctions the next 10 years.
When you say you're worried about debt levels, are you worried about global debt levels, U.S. debt levels in particular?
Let me explain. The crisis happened because we had two things taking place. Number one, a rise in complexity, hidden risks, less predictability, coupled with a rise in debt. Mm-hmm. Okay. What governments have done over the past year and a half is convert that private risk, private debt, instead of letting it collapse, convert it into public debt. Mm-hmm. Okay? Public debt. And you know what happens when debt goes from private to public? It stays there, and it's extremely hard to get rid of public debt.
But didn't we have to flood the market with liquidity because of the big credit freeze
Okay, the patient, and I've said it here, the patient had cancer. And what you do with the patient had cancer, you don't concentrate on painkillers. You focus on removing the tumor. I'm coming back a year and a half later. The tumor is bigger.
The debt is bigger.
The bad debt is bigger. The only drastic measure that I saw, the only hope, is what they did to Greece by forcing the Greeks, to tighten their belt. And even at the cost of incurring difficulties in the economy, you have to realize that the culprit is debt. The culprit is not a recession. Yeah. The culprit is hidden risks of debt.
Whether they can actually adhere to the austerity measures.
The Greeks, but I think the problem, look, what I saw is us, it's Europeans. Even the Europeans who are lecturing the Greeks are not in much better shape. I understand Portugal and Ireland are in bad shape, but even France, you see? So everyone is in the same boat. France have had deficits now for close to 39 years in a row, okay? We have a problem today, government should shoot for a surplus because the environment is much more unpredictable than before.
I thought most economists, though, said that when we were in this crisis, there's no choice but to just load up on debt, hair the dog that bit me, a hangover cure. The problem is what you do after that crisis is passed.
Let's forget about what was done. What we need to do today is focus on removing the tumor because it's growing every day. And let me tell you what I'm worried. When I hear you talk about auctions.
The 10-year that we just had.
The 10-year, okay. I know that the government thinks they're going to have $5 to $6 trillion to borrow the next 10 years. They're going to be, of course, competing with European governments.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You're going to be also competing with other with corporates
and so on. So interest rates will go up and the cost of debt will
go up. One day, you're going to have a bad auction. And that day would be the start of something new.
And that would be a black swan?
To me, it's not a black swan. It may be a black swan for the Obama administration. A bridge is very fragile. One truck is going to break that bridge.
So what is the alternative? I guess, I understand, and your thoughts and feelings about the excess debt are shared by a number of people that we have on the air here every day on CNBC. I guess the question is, what is the alternative method to address the underlying issue that would be more effective than what is happening now?
Okay, it's very simple. Blood, sweat, and tears. I keep repeating. What we need to do is what we did to the Greeks. Or we're trying to do the Greeks.
They do it to ourselves.
To everyone. Unfortunately, in a democratic environment, it doesn't work.
Right.
It only works when you do it to someone else.
Good luck with that, Nassim.
Good luck with that. So the solution may be hyperinflation. And nobody in Washington wants hyperinflation. They probably would be dreaming of a 3.25% inflation, mild inflation, except that you don't never get mild inflation when you want it.
Right.
You may get deflation, and then one day you will have a massive panic, with people buying gold or something else.
Well, they're doing that right now. Is that what the gold market is telling us?
Yeah, you may have a snap in currencies, what I call currencies without a government.
Right.
People flooding these, and that will cause, in turn, a rise of inflation expectations.
You'd mentioned a phrase, I believe you said, the administration is doing a bad job at risk management.
Yes.
Did I get that right?
Our
administration What did you mean?
What is risk management? I have receipts, I have an income, I should shoot to have a surplus because there are uncertainties in the environment. I don't know what expenses I'm going to have. The administration, when I look at, has a lot of debt, and it has a lot of moral liabilities. Like, for example, rescuing New York City after if one of the big firms, I will not mention its name, has difficulties. You see, you may have the administration has a liability to save New Yorkers. You have a lot of liabilities. In other words, the debt that we may incur may be a lot larger than the $5 or $6 trillion that they're projecting for the next 10 years. It may be considerably larger, and nobody seems to be aware of that.
About it.
Yeah, but like Larry Summers seems to be treating the U.S. economy the way he treated Harvard with his bogus projections. Mm-hmm. You see, my black swan problem comes from people making forecasts that are extremely fragile.
Okay, I need to ask you two questions. Were you at the time of Thursday's market event an advisor to Universal Fund?
I don't know. I'm not involved in any.
I'm just trying to straighten out the record because you're quoted as being so in the Wall Street Journal.
No, I am in general risk advisor to Universa.
Okay.
I am not involved. I don't know their position. I'm not involved in their trading.
That's fine. I'm just trying to get that straight.
Yeah.
And the second issue is, if indeed we had a black swan event on Thursday, and I'm not asking you to comment on that because I know you can't, there is a move afoot in Washington to investigate and try and find out the cause and perhaps regulate the markets in response to Thursday's event. Correct or not correct?
I have to think about it. I mean, this is not...
Okay, then I got another one for you. Throw a curveball. You made your entire career on this black swan thing.
Yeah,
it's what's going to be in your obit someday.
Yeah.
Do you think it ever colors your view to the negative always, to where you sell the dupe because it's part of your brand?
You may have positive black swans, but to be able to capture the positive black swans, you need to be protected from the negative ones. And my big negative black swan isn't something similar to Thursday. My big negative black swan is a failed auction.
I'm going to push back on you one more time because I got it. It's my job, okay?
Yes.
We had a 1,000-point drop in the Dow Jones Industrial Average.
Yes.
At the same time, you had riots in Greece. At the same time, you had the euro collapsing.
Yeah.
At the same time, you had spreads widening out and blowing out in the government bond market and the corporate bond market, high yield and investment grade.
Yes.
Put them all together.
Yeah.
Could it possibly have been a black swan? regardless of what you know or don't know about
the
mini S&P futures?
I mean, these events happen more frequently than we think. They may be black swans for people who are not taking them into account, their possibility into account, and they would be what I call gray swans or perhaps white swans for those who are prepared. The idea of a black swan, it depends. The black swan depends on the observer. In my book, I talk about the turkey and the butcher. Okay?
Right.
On Thanksgiving, minus 2 days, is a black swan for the turkey, but not a black swan for the butcher. And my whole idea is let's not be turkeys. And my business is to protect people, prevent them from being turkeys.
All right. Wow, there's all kinds of mixed metaphors going on here, but it's still pretty effective.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thanks again. And see you in 11 months.
See you in 11 months.